Welcome to the 1997 Okanagan Challenge Points Championship Snowmobile Hill Climb. Held at the top of the sunny Okanagan Valley at Silver Star Mountain in Vernon, British Columbia.
We're having fun.
After registration, most riders are back out with their machines doing those last-minute adjustments and fine-tuning for the competitive weekend ahead. A routine driver's meeting is held, advising all competitors of the rules and changes for the weekend.
Most of you have been here before. The way we run the pits, we have pre-staging in the, it's purple ribbon area. You'll be assigned a staging spot on the big blackboard, and you'll have a spot either in the first or the second row.
Last year's Trail Mod champion, Sean Semenoff, makes the first run of the weekend to test the course on his all-new 1998 XC600 short track Polaris. Day one of qualifying begins.
7.025.
Saturday morning, qualifying continues.
Oh!
That's good. I'd give them.
Brother-in-law.
Sunday morning, a drastic change in the weather could make things extremely difficult for riders as the track turns to ice and visibility to zero.
What is your name and where are you from?
Carl Mintz, Prince George, British Columbia. I ride a Ski-Doo Summit 583 today, and I'm from Prince George, where I work at the Forest Power Sports Ski-Doo dealership there.
Rocky Turcotte from Clearwater. Ride Polaris, ride for Half Mountain out of Clearwater.
Rick Harks, I'm from Kamloops, BC. I got a F3 Ski-Doo and a 500 Summit. My sponsors are Hallmark, Ford, Ski-Doo Racing, 100 Mile Recreation, Valley Fuel Injection.
Hi, I'm Jack Grace from OMAC, Washington. Well, I ride for a number of sponsors, OMAC Marine, Country Rock and Bark, D&D Auto Body, Arctic Cat, and Black Magic. And I'm riding three different sleds today in four classes. I ride a 580 Powder Special, a ZRT 600, and a ZRT 800.
My name is David Shepard, and I'm from Jackson, Montana. I ride a Polaris. It's like Reed's and that. It's a home-built chassis out of chromoly tubing. And starting line does my motors, and we own a garage down there, Shepherd's Garage, and my dad and I run it, and we get a lot of help from there.
Kevin Mintz, Kamloops, BC. I ride ZR440, Powder Extreme, and I ride for Leading Edge, Arctic Cat, Opti Oils, and Survival on Snow.
Lee Grove, I'm from Chetwynd, BC. I'm sponsored under my dad's company. I ride a ZRT 600. I run in improved stock and trail mod classes. So.
What is your dad's company?
Sid Grove Contracting.
Don Curtis from Cornell.
Okay, Don, what do you ride and who do you ride for?
I got a 680 Ultra and a Mod 800, and I ride for Outback, BC.
Yeah.
What do you think of the course this year?
This year it's the same as last year, but last night they changed the course and it's getting pretty tough up at the top there with the ice and the big holes and ruts and stuff that you have to cut across and through.
Awesome course, very fast. Fast times today.
Pretty good, a little easier than last year, not as steep at the top, but it's always good for some bumps.
Oh, it's a good course. It's a learner for me. I'm not quite into the snowcross yet, but it's good hill. I've been to all the BC climbs and a lot of good guys and pretty competitive out here.
Oh, I like it. This kind of course fits me. On the bottom, you know, it's kind of flat, moguly, a lot of turns, and then up on top where it's steeper, they let you use some thunder.
Last year, previous couple years, it's been a lot harder in the last 2-3 years. Like the jumps are more difficult. They're more off camber when you're hitting the jumps. So when you landed, it's really shooting you off the sled. So I don't know. This year seems a little bit easier than the previous. But today I think it's going to change. They made some off camber jumps on the way up the hill, so it's going to be different today.
Oh, it's good. This is the first time I've ever been to Vernon for the hill climb, and it's really good. It's fun and it's fast, so it's pretty good.
Oh, it's awesome. Yeah, it's a good course, really good course.
Are you happy with what the BCSF is doing this year?
Oh, I'm grateful that the BCSF is doing such a good job there, putting on races like this and getting all riders from all over Canada as well as the United States. They're doing a good job this year.
Are there any changes that you'd like to see?
I can't say there is. I'd like to see a few more Yamahas possibly up here on the hill racing for next year. Other than that, everything's running smooth.
Yeah, super. Yeah, they got to keep working at it, but I think they're going in the right direction.
Are there any changes you'd like to see them make for next year?
I'm still a trail mod fan, so I'd like to see that class hang around. The lightweight sleds I like to ride, so the improved slot sleds are heavier, so that's just the only thing I'd like to see.
Yeah, they do a good job every year. Keep it going from year to year. It's nice to have an organization behind you to set up this. It's a lot of work.
Is there any changes that you'd like to see them make for next year?
Not really. They seem to get everything down pat.
Oh, very well. Gained a lot of friends out of the deal. They got good points events. It's swell people, and I don't think any of them deserve, you know, standing out here in the cold, but each and every one of them need a hand. They do a great job.
Okay, are there any changes that you'd like to see them make?
Yeah, I would. I don't like this double qualifier. That's the only thing I got. The one-day poke's good, one-day qualifier, and one-day final's good, but I don't like the double qualifier. But I'm here to race, not complain.
Oh, yeah, they have a really good circuit. You know, they got good people running it, organized, and they put on a good show here.
Are there any changes that you'd like to see them make maybe for next year?
No, just turn this weather off.
Actually, the BCSF's doing a good job. We cut our events down to, I believe, 6. Last year we had about 11, and it was too much for the riders to go to 11 events, I think. Strapped for cash, and you only have to qualify for 5 events for points, so I think it's a lot better. And Hallmark Ford's doing an excellent job with the truck they sponsored last 2 years now, so we're real happy with that.
Okay, you partially answered my next question, but we'll maybe elaborate on that a little bit. Are there any changes that you'd like to see the BCSF do for next season?
I'd like to see us start getting a lot more beginners in the races, get more people interested. Maybe we could have a bigger beginners class if guys don't want to race with the guys that seem to be winning consecutively, and get some younger guys coming into the sport. It'd be nicer to have a lot more, a lot bigger turnouts.
Yeah, last year they had too many races, it seemed like, and kind of hard on the pocketbook. This year with 6, it's perfect for how much money you get. You get breaks in between the races, and you don't spend all your money in one shot, so it's pretty good. But.
Are there any changes you'd like to see them make maybe for next year?
No, I went, I only missed Fernie Hill Climb, and all of them were good, and everyone said Fernie was excellent too, so I'm happy.
Oh yeah, we've had a lot of fun this year, lots of fun. It's ran really well. Everybody has fun. Yeah, it's pretty good.
Are there any changes you'd like to see them make for next year?
No, I'd like to see a couple more better hills in the circuit, eh? Which would be really nice.
It's gonna stay. Oh,
there she goes. Oh,
this is dangerous, Carl. Why do you do it?
Because it's dangerous.
Oh, it's just an adrenaline rush.
It's fun. Something I always do on the weekends, whether I'm racing or just riding.
Runner on the edge. When in doubt, pin it.
It's not dangerous. A lot of people think it is, but you know, it's just basically, you know, you're racing against other racers. But like when you take off from the starting line, it's just you versus the hill. You're not worried about the other competitors. You're the only guy on the hill, and you know, people have gotten hurt at it, but in all reality, it's not that dangerous.
Because it's dangerous and it's fun. I don't know. It's the fun we have as a group. All the guys are friends. We all get together every weekend, and the snow's falling on us. No, it's pretty good. It's a good time. We all enjoy ourselves, and I never really thought about why we do it.
That's, well, any dangerous sport, everyone likes to watch and everyone likes to do it because it's a challenge, I guess. The harder it is on you, the more of a challenge it is, and you just want to do it. So
I don't know, it's kind of in my blood. I've raced for a lot of years, eh, and cars, now I'm into snowmobiles. Just in your blood, I guess.
We'll be right back.
How fast do you go?
I try to go as fast as I possibly can, but that doesn't mean other guys are faster than me or slower than me.
Just as fast as it'll go. Hold her the bar.
As fast as it'll go. To the bars.
Fast as she'll go, that throttle wide open.
On a course like this, I suppose maybe 40, 50 miles an hour, but there's some courses down in the States there where they've had radar guns and we've been radared up to 70.
Well, full throttle, why would you let off?
Not fast enough?
Anywhere from probably 50 mile an hour and up, 70, 80. A lot of guys really honking pretty, really hot sleds there.
You've gone as fast as 80 miles an hour?
Oh, I think so, yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure. Oh.
What is your biggest fear when you're on a run?
Getting beat by my little brother.
There is no fear, just go.
Losing.
I don't think about fear.
A course like this is making mistakes. It's basically a 44 to 40 second run, and one mistake, you know, you're out of the money. So your main concentration is no mistakes, a nice smooth run.
Don't have any fear. I don't know. I guess it's probably rolling the sled down to the bottom of the hill and watching it kind of disintegrate on the way down.
Crashing?
crashing. And it's happened lots to me this year. Barkerville was bad, really bad in Barkerville. I guess I had the best crash there.
So you've had a few crashes, is that what happened here?
Yeah, it kind of broke in a lot of pieces and we had to pot rivet it all back together and find all the parts. You gotta have a hood to run with, so I just made it look good.
Yeah. How do you know when you are having a good run?
It feels right. You're making good time. Your arms are stretching. Adrenaline's running. And you're out of control.
You feel it when you get up to the top. You can tell when you're pulling good speed and, you know, a good clean run and not a lot of slowing down in the berms and that, yeah.
Usually when you get down to the bottom and everybody tells you how fast or how slow you were.
Well, it all depends. Going into the corners level and things are smooth and you don't screw up, you don't come off your sled, things are seeming fast and you can see the top of the hill quick.
You're in rhythm and you're attacking corners really hard and you're not on one ski or the other and track's on the ground.
If you get into trouble where you have to let off the throttle, like back right off, then you know you've had a pretty bad run. If you're having a good run, you're on the throttle consistently all the way up the hill and there's no mistakes. You know you got a good run going.
You can just tell if you pick a good line and you're not getting bounced all over and you keep your speed up through the whole run, you can pretty well tell.
When you make it over the top and got a fast time.
Do you have any words for your sponsor?
Thanks a lot for the sled, and hopefully we can do this again next year.
Just keep up the good work.
Thanks for everything. Without you guys, I wouldn't be here.
Well, I'd like to thank each and every one of them again. Like I said, OMAC Marine, Country Rock and Bark, D&D Auto Body, Arctic Cat, and Black Magic. And it's been a great year, and I couldn't do it without them.
I'd just like to thank them, you know, without them, like anybody around here, if you didn't have sponsors, you couldn't do it unless you had a big fat pocketbook, and I'd just like to thank them. It's Starting Line Products, Polaris, Shepherd's Garage, and I think that's about it.
I'd like to thank Arctic Cat this year. They've done a good job for both me and Jason. But there are sleds, Jimmy Anzu at Arctic Cat, he's really helped us out. Opti Oils for sponsoring. Survival on Snow for giving us Troubles probes and Travelance transceivers and Leading Edge Motorsports. That's Jason's sled there, and we've been doing good this year, so I'd like to thank them.
No, other than thanks, and I wouldn't be able to be doing this if I didn't have a sponsor. It costs a lot of money, so.
They've been really good to me this year. I just hope they give me more for next year.
Number 167, Taylor Flora.
Track conditions, as you've heard, are pretty icy here today, but we're going to make the best of it. Visibility on the hill, even though we have snow, is not bad. Some of the smaller sleds with no traction aids are giving us problems here, but we'll get through it one way or another, and I think it should turn out good. we'll just hope this weather lifts and look for better things.
Thanks very much. Reed Edlin from Midway, BC. Good luck to you, Reed.
My name is Pat Whiteway, and I help out with the pit, running the pit, and organizing the racers, getting them through on time and that kind of thing, basically.
Okay, and what does that fully involve, running the pit?
Running the pit means that we need to get all the drivers pre-staged into the areas, ready in a timely fashion to get through in the start gate and so forth.
And how long have you been doing this for?
Actually, we've been doing this now about our fifth year, and I've been heavily involved in it. To that point. A lot of help here in the pits, and it's with that help that it gets done.
Oh.
Despite the weather conditions, these diehards heard there was a snowmobile hill climb at Silver Star, and they want to see it.
Show me a hat.
name's Ron Day. I'm the event organizer, and I'm from Kelowna.
Okay, you're the event organizer. So what do you do?
Basically coordinate everything, make sure the event runs smoothly. There's quite a few different areas. There's security, hail help, fencing, pits. So I try and take care of it all, and I have key guys that I go to, and it runs fairly smoothly. We learn every year. This is our sixth year.
Yeah.
Let's not forget our proud sponsors of this 1997 Okanagan Challenge Hill Climb. Husky. Here in the Okanagan, it's Husky. And the Okanagan's very own CHBC-TV. Flag posts are repositioned, leaving an open hill for riders to choose their own course for the final Dash for Cash event.
Nice run. Oh. Right there.
Nice, nice.
Roll. Boom. They're pretty low, eh? Like, they don't get up to big.
Oh, no.
Oh, that's perfect. Look at that.
It's a good thing it's a cat.
This driver's got to have rings out there.
Wait to see the video. I watched it over and over and over again. Anyways, I'd like to thank all the racers, the volunteers, if we have any spectators here. Without any of you guys, we're nothing. And just thank everybody, because I think the whole event is growing at a very good pace, and we try and make improvements every year, and I believe next year will be bigger and better. Thank you.